Hello and welcome. I'm so glad that you could join the Flesh Limerick Pastoral Charge for some fun and music today as we continue our Advent season and start a little Christmas a little early. I invite you to check out our website at www.lafleshlimerickunited.com to see all of the cool things that we're up to between now and Christmas, and hopefully we'll get a chance to see you at some of them. Before we get into this music, let's take a moment for prayer. This comes to us from Celebrate God's Presence, which is a United Church service book. It has lots of different prayers and liturgy in it, and I really liked this one. Let us pray. Gracious God, your vision of peace and wholeness comes to us in sweeping revelations and in tiny signs of hope. Kindle our hearts that we might be a hopeful people. Keep us from growing weary of waiting, lest we miss the glory of your appearing. Even so, come quickly, O God. Amen. The coming of the Messiah was long foretold by the prophets, and so today we sing our expectation. Written by Charles Wesley, this hymn has the quality of a petition, a prayer that implores Christ to be among us. In it, we can almost hear the Jews of Jesus' own time singing as they await the Messiah, even as we hear our own voices taking up the plea as we await his return. Written and usually sung as an Advent hymn, we sing it today as we draw ever closer to the birth of our Lord. So let us sing with joyful hearts, Come, Thou Long-Expected Jesus. Our next hymn is a medieval hymn by Henrik Suso, translated, paraphrased, and really made popular by John Mason Neal in 1853. Originally a folk carol, it has found its way into many hymn books and is sung in churches of many different denominations. In its three short verses, it tells of God's love and salvation, with the last line of each stanza hammering home the point. Christ is born today. Christ was born for this. Christ was born to save. So let us join our voices as we sing of God's love made known in Jesus Christ. often marvel at the faith that Mary and Joseph must have needed. In the grand scheme of things, we know little of them, yet we know of their faith. And so today, as people of faith have done for generations, we gather to tell the story of God's love coming to the world as a little child, to recount the story of Jesus' birth. Our next hymn has been attributed to many different authors, but was translated from the original Latin into English by Frederick Oakley in 1841. In the second verse, you may recognize material from the Nicene Creed, reminding the singer exactly who Jesus is, God. The rest of the song tells the Christmas story and implores all the faithful to come and worship. So let us gather, let us sing, and let us worship as we sing together, O Come, All Ye Faithful. As David was born in Bethlehem, so too was the Christ child, another king of the line of David. And so today we sing of that tiny town with such a prominent place in the history of our faith. This hymn was written by Bishop Philip Brooks, an Episcopal priest in Philadelphia in the late 1800s. Inspired by his time in Bethlehem, Bishop Brooks wrote the carol for a Sunday school Christmas service, never thinking that it would be used again. And yet it was, for its simple truths and beauty speak to our souls. So as we sit in our own homes today, let us lift our voices and let our minds wander to another place and another time as we sing O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
often attributed to the German reformer Martin Luther, our next hymn is actually more likely to be of an American composition. It has many tunes and many variations of lyrics, but however you sing it, it tells the simple story of the Christ child's birth and has come to be a favorite carol of children and adults alike. Let's join our voices as we join in singing Away in a Manger. Charles Wesley was a prolific hymn writer, and our next song is another of his. Interestingly, he originally titled it Hymn for Christmas Day, and has imagined it as set to slow and solemn music. The opening line was also different than we now know it, with "Hark how all the welkin rings, glory to the King of Kings." Thankfully, there have been some changes over the years. Let's join our hearts and voices in singing Hark the Herald Angels Sing. This afternoon reminds us to ask the question, what child is this, as we celebrate our Christmas season? When we find him in the manger, he has as yet done no miracles, he has given no sermons, he has not risen from the grave. Yet these magi from another place, another culture, recognize this child for who he is and who he will become. Can we do the same? This next hymn is another one for which we do not precisely know its origin. It is believed to be a German or Austrian lullaby, remembering what Mary might have sung to the sleeping Christ child. There are 6 verses in the original German and many different English verses to go with it, but today we'll only sing 3 as you join in this quiet lullaby. Our next hymn today was not originally written to tell the Christmas story, as you'll notice that there is no manger, no angels, no shepherds, not even a baby Jesus. Instead, based on Psalm 98, it speaks of the world as Isaac Watts, its writer, believes it will be when God reigns after Christ's triumphant return at the end of the age. A time when there is no more sin or sorrow, a time when all creation will sing that God has brought salvation to the world. It is a hymn that tells the story of God's love coming into the world in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago, at the second coming of Christ, and into every heart. And so it has become a beloved Christmas carol. So let us sing it with hearts filled with the joy of God's love for creation. Joy to the world. Like many wonderful hymns, our next song is based on a poem. In 1872, English poet Christina Rossetti published a poem called A Christmas Carol, which has since been formed into the hymn In the Bleak Midwinter. In its first verse, we imagine the night on which Jesus came to earth. And in the last, we contemplate what we can do and bring to the Christ child. So let's sing together. Thank you. It's hard to track down the history of our next carol, particularly because of its history in slavery and colonialism. As such, the only attribution that is often given is a West Indies carol, and we know little more than that. Nevertheless, its words remind us of the great truth that the glorious kingdom of God came to earth the night Jesus was born. So let us sing, "The Virgin Mary Had a Baby Boy." We're nearing the end of our time together, but it wouldn't be a Christmas carol sing if we didn't sing Silent Night. This 202-year-old song was written by Father Joseph Mohr, a young priest in Austria, and was put to music by Franz Xaver Gruber. Its simple words and beautiful melody hold our imaginations and, yes, tug on our heartstrings as it is sung around the world each year.
Yeah.
Final carol of the afternoon is one of my all-time favorites, and since I set the program for this, you get to end with it. It's an African-American spiritual which tells the story of Jesus's birth and the angels' insistence that the shepherds go to share the good news. In his book, New Jubilee Songs, which was a compilation of spirituals, John Wesley Work Jr. recorded this hymn, and it has become a beloved Christmas carol ever since. So let's sing with joy as we go tell it on the mountain. I'm so glad that you took a little bit of time out of your day to join us for some fun and some singing and starting off our Christmas season. As I said, I hope you go and check out all the wonderful things that we're doing between now and Christmas and then again into the new year, and that we'll see you at some of them. Our closing benediction comes from Celebrate God's Presence, again, a United Church service book. Return now to our world with its pain and wonder. remembering the words of the prophets, the faithfulness of Mary, and the longing of all who yearn for a sign of hope. And may the blessing of God, who is ever faithful, the blessing of Christ, who still comes to us, and the blessing of the Holy Spirit, who moves with us and throughout the world, rest upon us and abide with us this day and forevermore. Amen.